Molality. What is this? Molality. See the difference between molarity and molality. There are two words, it appears similar, but in molarity we use the capital M. Capital M denotes molarity, small m denotes molality. So how to define it? You know, molality also can be defined using its formula. See the formula for molality. M is equal to N2 by W, 1 in kilograms. This is the formula. Here N2 means number of moles of solute. W1 means mass of solvent. Mass of solvent. So in kilograms. If a mass of solvent is given in grams na, then formula is N2 into 1000 by here W1 in grams. This is the formula. What is N2? N2 is the number of moles of solute. Already said that here for N2 means W2 by gram molecular weight 2. Number of moles of any substance how to get? Its weight by gram molecular weight. So if you substitute in the formula, finally we get M is equal to W2 into 1000 by gram molecular weight of solute into volume in ml. This is the formula. So from the formula, how to define it? See here, if W1 is nothing but 1 kilograms, let W1 be 1 kilogram, then number of moles of solute is nothing but molality. Okay, so how to define it? It is the number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent, not solution, 1 kg of solvent. So that is molality. So molality equals to, now how can we write another formula for molality? Weight into 1000 by gram molecular weight of solute into weight of solvent in grams. This is the formula. In the case of molarity, here we used the word volume in milliliters, but here weight of solvent in grams. That is the difference. Okay, so there in molarity, number of moles of solute per liter of solution, but here number of moles of solute per kg of solvent. That is the difference. Okay, so after the formula and the definition, what is the definition for it? See, number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent is called molality. Right. Next, how does it depend on temperature and what are its units? First, let's see its units. What are the units of molality? See, in the numerator there are number of moles, in the denominator weight of solvent. That's why mole per kg, mole per kg, it is the unit of molality. Or often we use molal, molal. Molar means molarity, molal means molality. Or we can use small m also. So mole per kg or molal or small m, these are the representations of units of molality. Now how does it depend on temperature? See, in this formula, in any formula of molality, is there any volume term? No. That's why molality does not depend on temperature. Does not depend on T. T means temperature. Next, here also some cases. What are the cases? If percentage W by V is given, if percentage W by W given, how to find out molality? First case, if X percentage W by W is given, W by W is given, how to find out molality? So W by W means X percentage means X by 100. X is the mass of solute, 100 is the mass of solution. Mass of solution, always in the percentage symbol, numerator is of solute, denominator is of solution. So X percentage W by V is given as, see, M is equal to, What is the mass of solute? From this formula we can substitute. What is the mass of solute? X grams. So in place of W2 place X. Already 1000 there is, that's why 1000x by gram molecular weight of solute into, how to write the solvent weight? Here X by 100, X is the mass of solute, but 100 is the mass of total solution. But in the formula, there is the term of solvent and not of solution. That's why 100 is the mass of solution. X is the mass of solute. How to get mass of solvent? Mass of solvent is equal to mass of solution minus mass of solute. So mass of solution already 100, mass of solute X. So this is the formula to use. If percentage W by W is given, this is the formula to use, find out the, to calculate the molality of the solution. Sometimes if X percentage W by V and density or specific gravity will be given. If these two are given, how to find out the molality? See, they are also similar. M is equal to X percent means, here X percent means X by 100. X is the mass of solute, 100 is the volume of solution, because there is W by V. So volume of solution here 100, mass of solute is X. So how to find out molality in this case? 1000x. Why 1000x? Volume, mass of solute is X, already there is 1000 in the formula, divided by gram molecular weight of solute into mass of solvent. How to write? Here we have only volume of solution. You know, mass is equal to volume into density. Mass is equal to volume into density. Volume we have 100, because percentage means volume of solution 100. Density D. So 100 into D gives what? Mass of solution. So 100 D is mass of solution minus mass of solute means X. So 100 into D minus X, this gives mass of solvent. So using this formula we can find out molality if X percent W by V is given. Okay, right, these are different formulae we can use for molality. Now let's see the relation between molality and molarity. Molality small m is equal to 1000 m by 1000 d minus molarity into gram molecular weight of solute. This is the direct formula and shortcut formula to convert. If molarity is given, to convert into molality, use this formula. So in other words, if molality is given, to convert it into molarity, use this formula. This is the shortcut formula to find out molality or molarity if any one of its if any one of them is given. Right, next, after molality, this molality does not depend on temperature, already I said that. And next, sixth term, last term, that is mole fraction. Mole fraction denoted by chi, the symbol is called chi, or in some books it is given as X. What is mole fraction? It is a fraction of moles. See, here how to find out a mole fraction of solute and solvent? Mole fraction of solute equals to number of moles of a solute by number of moles of solute plus solvent. That means mole fraction means it is the number of moles of one component to the total number of moles in the solution. We are discussing here binary solutions, that's why I wrote only two terms, N1 and N2. If there are three terms in the solution, then mole fraction of one component is equal to its moles by total N1 plus N2 plus N3. So in that way, based on the number of components in the solution, this denominator changes. Similarly, mole fraction of solvent equal to mole fraction of solvent equals to N1 by N1 plus N2. So if the solution is binary, we use this formula. If solution is ternary, then N1 by N1 plus N2 plus N3. If the solution is some quaternary, then N1 by N1 plus N2 plus N3 plus N4. In that way, denominator changes based on the type of solution, whether it is binary, ternary, quaternary. Here we are confining to binary, that's why mole fraction of solute, mole fraction of solvent only I wrote. You know, sum of mole fractions in a solution is equal to 1. That means mole fraction of solute, let it be x2 or chi2. This is chi1. So sum of mole fractions in a solution, chi1 plus chi2 is equal to 1. If there are so many components in a solution, then chi1 plus chi2 plus chi3 and so on equal to 1. Whatever be the number of components present in the solution, sum of mole fractions must be equal to 1. Similarly, you know, mole fraction of solute by mole fraction of solvent equal to number of moles of solute by number of moles of solvent. Why? See, mole fraction of solute means N2 by N1 plus N2. Mole fraction of solvent means N1 by N1 plus N2. That means ratio gives. When you take the ratio, what happens? Denominators in the both the terms gets cancelled. That's why ratio of mole fractions is equal to the ratio of moles. So this is the formula we use. Next, what are the units? Is it having any units? No. Why? Mole fraction is a ratio. Moles by moles. Moles by moles. That's why no units. Then what about temperature dependence? See here, any volume term in its formula, either mole fraction of solute or mole fraction of solvent contains any volume term? No. That's why it does not depend on temperature T. Okay, right. So these are the important points about mole fraction. Let's see the relation between mole fraction and molality. Molality equals to 1000 into mole fraction of solute by mole fraction of solvent into gram molecular weight of solvent. This is the formula. So here we can write it as 1000 into mole fraction of solute by mole fraction of solvent. How to write? Mole fraction of solvent is equal to 1 minus mole fraction of solute into gram molecular weight of solvent. So we can use this formula too. Now let's see the relation between molarity and mole fraction. Molarity is equal to 1000 into density into mole fraction of solute by 1 minus x2 into gram molecular weight of solvent. So this is the relation between molality, small m, molality and mole fraction of solute, molarity, capital M, to mole fraction of solute. These are all concentration terms.